All right, welcome everyone. What we're going to be doing right now is giving you a brief tutorial on how to complete this assignment, an inquiry into social emotional learning. So notice here that you have your task, your learning objective, and what you need to take a look at is this right here. If you're wondering why this activity is designed this way, you want to look at this, an inquiry-based instruction approach. This is designed to be a little bit more open-ended since we're trying to go out and determine our own research questions, gather evidence, and come to our own conclusions. So it's designed in a format that's articulated here. Now, the first step that you need to complete in order to do this assignment is you want to start by downloading this inquiry into social-emotional learning worksheet. And that looks just like this. And we'll have all of the steps of your research articulated. So what you'll do now is you'll say, okay, well, in the first step of this assignment, it asks me to look at the resources provided on iLearn and determine what is the problem faced by educators regarding students' social-emotional learning. So with that, what I'll do is I'll go through here and look at all of these resources underneath step two. I'm going to look at a brief overview and introduction of social-emotional learning. I'm going to look at different articles that present some various perspectives on how this might impact teachers. So after reviewing all of these resources in the second part, that's where I go and I determine, so what is it that's the main problem that's perplexing educators in schools when it comes to students' social-emotional learning? So articulate that in this box based on the resources provided in step two. Once you've done that, you're ready to go on to this right here, generating our research questions. Okay, we generate our research questions based on either questions that are already out there. So you could pick one of these questions that has to do with social emotional learning, or you can come up with your own research question. But you need to develop, or you need to identify and highlight, or come up with your own so that you have a total of two research questions. So either pick two or pick one and come up with your own, but identify what are the two research questions of these provided or your own that you would like to investigate during this assignment. Now, the next step will be to spend approximately 45 minutes to an hour researching as much as you can information related to each of your two research questions. So let's say that I decided to do this one. What skills are taught in social emotional learning programs? Well, I could put that research question right here, and I'm going to go out and be on the hunt for any information related to that, and also link to whatever source I got this information from. So if I come across an article that talks about, well, a lot of schools focus on these elements of social emotional learning, and that's related to my question, I'm going to put the information that I find right here and the source that it comes from right there. Now, you don't need to go out and find your own resources per se on each of your research questions. If you click right here where it says use these social emotional learning resources, you'll notice that some have been provided in different categories. So depending on your research question, you're going to identify which category or categories would have the resources that are best suited to your research question. And you're going to find as much information as you can in relation to the questions that you're researching. Split your time between the first research question you've identified and the second research question. And don't forget to quickly cite the source or just link to wherever it is that you got the information. So you notice that you have six boxes provided on each side. So if you can get six different pieces of information, and hopefully not all from the same source for each of your research questions, you will have done what it is we're asking you to do. And that is to collect and analyze information or data that relates to your two questions. Okay. Finally, after you've identified your own questions, researched each of your questions and cited your sources, you're going to come to conclusions, or partial conclusions at least, for each of your research questions. So again, let's say that my question was, what skills are taught in social emotional learning programs? I might come to a conclusion, a partial conclusion, such as, well, while schools don't really agree on what the best skills are, The most commonly taught skills based on the information presented are, you might come up with that. Or you might come to a more definitive conclusion that schools and national social emotional learning groups have identified, I'm going to make up a number here, 12 essential skills that should be taught in each of our schools. And they are, So these might be partial conclusions that you come to or complete conclusions, but you need to come to at least a partial or complete conclusion for each of your research questions. And it needs to be driven by the information that you went out and gathered and analyzed in relation to each of those questions.